Hey guys, I'm Nashwa. Welcome back to my channel. And today I'll be talking about Pakistani fiction, specifically my difficult relationship with Pakistani fiction. Now, this video will be done in two parts. The first is sort of a discussion about why I don't really get along with Pakistani fiction. And the second will be a list of books that I will try to read in the month of August to sort of fix that relationship, because August is our Independence Month and I just wanted to highlight Pakistani authors during this time. So before I get into the crux of the video, there's a couple of disclaimers that I want to give. Firstly, I'm not claiming to be any sort of a literary critic. I'm just a person on the internet who reads books and likes to talk about her opinions. And secondly, if your favorite book is on this list of the books that I don't like, please don't take it to mean as an attack on yourself. Different people like different things and we are all entitled to our opinions. So now that the disclaimers are out of the way, I can finally talk about the issues that I've had with Pakistani fiction, except we're not going to talk about Bapsi Sidhwa in this video, because Bapsi Sidhwa is an unproblematic queen, at least in my opinion. I discovered her recently. I've talked about her in many videos and I will do a dedicated video to her when I finish all her books. So the first issue that I have with Desi fiction is that I don't feel represented. And it's so strange to read a Pakistani novel which is set in Pakistan and it feels like this strange foreign land that you've never been to. And other than Bapsi Sidhwa's work, which I primarily identified with, I don't feel like I've read any book which made me feel like, wow, this book is really talking about, you know, my country, the country that I lived and grew up in. Not only do I not feel connected to the thematic elements or the environment of it, they just feel strange because I have never read a book that is set in the city that I live in. And I live in Islamabad, which is the capital. It's a very nice city. It's very beautiful. I would like to see the greenery or, you know, the imagery being depicted in any book. But I have yet to read a book, a Pakistani book that is set in Islamabad. And if there is a book that is set here, please do let me know. The second issue that I have with most Desi fiction, and I feel like this will be somewhat of an unpopular opinion, is that I think, specifically in my opinion, that Desi writers write to impress a Western audience. Hardly do I ever feel like they're writing for their own people, which again ties into my first point. But a lot of our books show the grim side of Pakistan, the dark side. We're talking about terrorist attacks, we're talking about the wars that we had in the past. And that is not the accurate depiction of the country. Sure, we've had those problems in the past. Sure, we're still dealing with all kind of religious and ethnic differences. But I feel like the books that win literary prizes are ones that are showing this side of Pakistan. And it just feels very weird to be talking about a book that is specifically talking about a terrorist attack. And I don't feel connected to it, because despite the terrorist attacks and the bombings and everything, like, the rest of the book is very, very hard to connect with. And with this, two specific examples come to mind. The first one is Home Fire by Kamila Shamsi. Read three of Kamila Shamsi's books. I consider her to be a very, very good writer, but I feel like her books are something that I've kind of not connected with fully. I feel like Cartography, again set in the 1970s in Karachi, talking about these like rich elite families, and Burnt Shadows was historical fiction, again with the whole Soviet-Afghan war. But Home Fire was one that won the International Women's Prize, I believe. And again, the entirety of it was kind of based on the fact that there would be a bombing, there would be a terrorist attack, someone got involved in a terrorist organization. And while that is somewhat a part of our history, that's not the entire sum of it. And similarly, Exit West by Mohsen Hamid is a book that I couldn't really get into, because again, I felt like the author, while the country remained unnamed in the book, the author is Pakistani. And the ideas in this book were about all these like poor people. And I feel like writers like Mohsen Hamid also write because they like to add shock value. So they will deliberately write about explicit things to like shock the audience and sort of, you know, make it seem like, wow, this information is coming out of Pakistan, which again, it's something that I absolutely cannot connect with. My third point is the existence of these hidden subcultures that seem to emerge in Pakistani fiction, which are the excessive use of drugs and alcohol. And yes, it is a reality in the hidden subculture, because if you don't know, Pakistan practices prohibition. It's a law that doesn't really affect me. It was passed in 1978, way before I was born. This is a topic that Pakistani authors have wrung dry. The first example that comes to mind was Mohsen Hamid. Mohsen Hamid's first book was Mot Smoke, in which he talks about this hidden party culture, because alcohol is publicly banned. So he talks about this, like these parties that these rich people go to. And I give credit where credit's due, even though I'm not a fan of Hamid's work. Mot Smoke is one book that is still very fresh in my memory. And I read it in 2006 when it came out. So I remember most of the plot. And initially that idea was kind of innovative, where you're talking about like these things that no one else was talking about. So I'll give him credit for like talking about that one thing. But after that, every other book that you pick up, they'll be talking about drugs and alcohol. And I don't know who needs to hear this, but talking about drugs and alcohol is not interesting. Like, fine, you can explore that lifestyle if you're into it. If you don't drink, good for you. If you do drink, good for you. Like, that's not the point. But if you are putting it so much in your fiction and in your literature, it does not make it cool and or unique. It's just not interesting. So I got interrupted in the middle, so I'm just going to try to continue from where I left off, which was talking about the excessive use of drugs and alcohol in our desi fiction. Mothsmoke was one, memorable, new, it was done. Then I read a book called Goodbye Freddie Mercury. I actually didn't make it all the way through because I just got bored. I DNF'd it temporarily. By DNF I mean did not finish, but I plan to fully come back to it because I want to give it one more chance. And the first page of this book is this girl who is super cool, and she's super cool because she can roll a joint like no one else. And that's just, sure, it's interesting. She's not like other girls, because other girls in Pakistan probably can't roll a joint as well. And one other book that explores this tired old tirade or trope is Karachi, You're Killing Me. And if you're planning to read this book, don't read this book. It will be a waste of your time. This book is about a young journalist, early 20s, who just started working and is annoyed at her boss most of the time. But she is also a party girl, and that is something that makes her super cool, because she goes drinking every night. And the only words that you will hear in this book are booze and alcohol and party and going out and constantly complaining about being broke. Essentially, the story was very tropey. This girl initially is convinced that she's not in love with her best friend, but in the end there's a whole airport chase scene where, you know, he's leaving or she's leaving and they confess, you know, that they're in love with each other. There, I've spoiled the ending for you. You don't have to read this book at all. But it was just so problematic in the way that it was portraying women. And I remember there was a scene where this main character, she is having an affair or just, you know, has a sexual encounter with a white journalist. And then she goes on to say that white guys just do it better. And I don't know if it's just me, but that kind of sounds like a fetish to me. Like, why are we fetishizing white people? And I honestly wouldn't be surprised if this author used the word exotic to describe the desi girl as something that her white character would say. It just wouldn't surprise me at all. So now that I've discussed all the problems I have with desi fiction, I'm going to give it another chance, and I'm going to read some of the books that I did not finish, and just to improve my relationship with desi fiction, because I feel like there are a lot of good writers out there and they deserve to be highlighted, because I don't want to constantly complain about the fiction that I'm reading. So on average, I read about 4 books a month. And right now I will talk about 8 books to give myself options to pick and choose out of them. But the goal is to read at least 4 Pakistani books this month. And I'll try to vlog the process, even though I know vlogging in August is going to be really difficult because there's a lot of things going on in my family. So it'll just be strange to come take a break every now and then, but I can do like more sit down kind of videos. Let me know what's the preferred method. If you prefer vlogs or more sit down like videos or both, just for variety. So let me show you the 8 books that I'm giving myself the option of reading. Out of them, I will definitely try to read 4. 7 are fiction, and I've included 1 non-fiction because I wanted to try that as well. So I won't go into a lot of detail about the synopses of these books, because some of them I haven't read at all and some of them I've DNF'd and I've forgotten what happened. So I'll just read little bits of the inside covers. So the first book is Goodbye Freddie Mercury by Nadia Akbar, purely a cover by, but also like a title by. And this book is basically set in the city of Lahore. Lahore is burning. General elections are right around the corner. The summer city rages with the drug-fueled parties of the oblivious, the rich and famous, while campaign poster and rally cries dominate the airwaves. Akbar's audacious debut has all the makings of a cult novel. Parties, drugs, mysteries, love triangles, political intrigue and power struggles. But its lush, sexy writing has the assuredness and precisions of the most acute style of our time. Told in alternating voices and brimming with sharp observation, Goodbye Freddie Mercury hits the rocks and trails of a twist. Okay, the last line I read a little weird, but it generally gives you an idea that it's about young people who are really into partying, rock and roll. I remember the main character was struggling with the death of her brother, but I don't know if the topic of grief is handled in this book at all. The second one is called This Wide Night by Sarwat Haseen. The Maliks live a life of relative freedom in 1970s Karachi. Four beautiful sisters, Maria, Aisha, Leila, and Bina, are rarely watched over by their unconventional mother. Captain Malik is usually away, and so the women forge the rules of their own universe, taking in a few men. In the quietly seething world of This Wide Night, Little Women meets the virgin suicides in Pakistan. Moving from Karachi to London and finally to the rain-drenched island of Menora, here is a compelling new novel from the subcontinent and a powerful debut to watch. So again, two debuts. The next two are collections of short stories, so In Other Rooms, Other Wonders by Danial Muinuddin. These stories are dark and light, complex and humane, at heart about the relationship between the powerful and the powerless, bound together in life and in death. Together, they make up a vivid portrait of a feudal world rarely brought alive in the English language. Sensuous, graceful, melancholy, In Other Rooms, Other Wonder gives you Pakistan as you have never seen it. It marks the debut of new amazing talent. You know, this says new talent, so it's obviously a debut novel, except I bought this in 2009 when it first came out. I remember being very clearly that I was in university and someone suggested it to me. And I have tried to read this multiple times and I've never made it past the first two stories. So I'm going to attempt this one. The next one is another collection of short stories called Saints and Charlatans by Sarim Beg. This, I believe, came out in 2018 or 16. Let me check. 2018 by Mongrel Books, which is a Pakistani company. And I ordered it, and let me just read that this series of interlinked stories set in contemporary Punjab, which is a province in Pakistan, explores how the increasing intolerance of society compels individuals to become either saints or charlatans, and how it's sometimes hard to tell the difference. So again, a series of short stories that I would like to get to. The next one is The Light Blue Jumper by Sidra F. Sheikh. And I started reading this book. My bookmark is still in it. I'm on page 42, but I'll start reading it again because this was a couple of weeks ago. And I put it down because I wanted to finish Emma. I was quite surprised to see that I accidentally or maybe intentionally got a signed copy. And that's just really interesting because signed copies are not a thing here. But when I started reading this, it started to remind me a little bit of The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. So it's science fiction and it's really, really funny. Like, you have all these interesting characters, and from the 42 pages that I read, short chapters, they keep you engaged. But let me just read a little bit off the back, which says, "Join the cast of this comedy of errors set in space as they rally behind a most reluctant hero to fight oppression, imperialism, and bad manners." So I know that this is part of a series because I watched the author's interview in a YouTube video, which I'll leave linked below in case you're interested. So that makes it more exciting because I don't know of many Pakistani series. Like, I know of Urdu books having like multiple series and volumes and things like that, but a Pakistani science fiction series is something that's definitely very exciting. The next one is nonfiction, a series of essays called Points of Entry by Nadeem Farooq Paracha. And he, I believe, is a famous journalist or a writer, someone whose name has popped up in multiple articles that I've read. And I believe like this is more like his travelogue because I did try to read it. I've marked it, but then for some reason or the other, I ended up putting it down to pick up at a later time. Hopefully that later time has arrived. Pakistan is more than the sum of its news-making parts. In this series of essays on history, politics, and society, the author Nadeem Farooq Paracha upturns reductive readings of the country by revealing its multi-layered reality. With wit and insight, he investigates events from Pakistani history as also their implication for its modern-day society. So I realize that I can't read out aloud, which makes me really self-conscious, but I just wanted to give you an accurate description of the books. The next one is called Rafina by Shandana Minhas, and I believe that Shandana Minhas, the author, is somehow affiliated to the publishing company Mongrel Books, which basically gave us these two books, which is The Light Blue Jumper and Saints and Charlatans. So this book is about a girl called Rafina who looks at the glamorous girl on the billboard outside her window in Karachi and thinks, "It won't be too long before I'm up there." Too poor for college and dismissive of marriage, the clear-eyed young woman cajoles her mother's friend and Radiance Beauty Parlor masseuse Rosie Hala, taking her into apprenticeship until she is discovered. So this is one that I've been meaning to read for a long time, but I just haven't gotten to it. And the last book that I will attempt to read in August is The Bride by Bapsi Sidhwa. I hate this cover. I cannot stand the hands and, you know, the gold and the red. It's just too much, but I guess it goes with the title. Hopefully, I will be reading this as a buddy read with my friend and subscriber, Joe Smith. So this book is about a man called Qasim, who is from the mountainous area, which are the northern areas of Pakistan. He comes across an orphaned child called Zaitoon, And he takes her to Lahore and he raises her, and then he marries her off into the mountainous area, into the tribe there. And then she tries to escape from there. Because this is way too long for me to read like properly without, you know, hurting you all by making you listen to it. But that's just a little bit of a synopsis. So that's it. These are the 8 books that I talked about in this video, and I'm really hoping to get through 50% of this pile and the remaining 4 to read one each month until the end of the year, because I would like to finish this pile off by reading it, not burning it, by the end of this year. So if you stuck it all the way through, thank you so much for watching. Of course, I'm always here to listen to your comments, or read your comments rather, about anything that I've said, whether it's about the discussion and my issues, if you disagree or agree, or if it's about any of the books that you're interested in. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.